Vsauce, I'm Ethan, and what you're looking at is an interpretation of reality. It's raw numbers that software converts into a visual representation of the moments captured. It's data.
And data can be corrupted. If we remove this visual layer to see what is underneath, this is what we get: movie atoms. These atoms contain all of the information that describe the video's data, the software used to edit it, the music used, the name of the video files included, to this, the video itself, the one you are currently watching. The raw data of what was recorded, not yet processed through software to become a moving image that we can decipher, that we can see. If this is what we're given after recording, then what does the camera see while recording? Almost every digital sensor what captures the image does so by first gathering light into photo sites. To help visualize this, let's use Ethan as a red photo site, Gila as green, and myself as blue.
But there are more than three photo sites on a sensor.
A lot more, because this camera records in 8K resolution.
Very true, Ethan. So we are going to have to multiply ourselves. About 11.6 million times. This sensor has around 35 million photo sites. Half of those are green, a quarter blue, and a quarter red. There are more green sites because green light makes up roughly twice as much of our perception of brightness than red and blue. If we look at the visible spectrum, our eyes are much more sensitive to shades of green. But back to photo sites. They're like buckets that collect photons. We have our red, green, and blue ones that allow the correct color in, while filtering out the two that don't. Once captured, it reads it as an electrical signal and stores it as a value in a digital file like we saw earlier. And then this is what we're left with, a grid of RGB. If you look at it from far enough away, it almost resembles a fully colored image. But up close, it is easy to see each individual pixel. To produce full color pixels, it goes through an algorithmic process, demosaicing or debayering. Think of it as color mixing, where it takes specific values of each photo site and combines them to produce what color is surrounding it, giving us an image that looks real. Our eyes are much better at perceiving luminance, brightness, and not so good with chroma, color. Which is why more green is captured, since that better represents luma. It is also why you might have not noticed that the red and blue color channels have been blurred this whole time. Let's fix that. Now let's look at another example. What color are these strawberries?
Red.
Red?
If you said red, then you are wrong. This image was created by psychology professor Akiyoshi Kitaoka, and it demonstrates how poorly we generally see color. Every pixel in that image is gray, and some are a gray with a little bit of green in it. Our brain is, in a sense, color correcting. It is taking out the perceived blue and leaving us with what appears to be red strawberries, even though they aren't. But how do we know what color is a color? And how does a camera sensor know? Well, we know this is purple, orange, yellow, and pink because we were told that. Someone somewhere in our lives told us what color was what color. So how does a camera sensor know what color is? That is to say, how does what this camera is recording right now know that this is blue? And more importantly, how does it know what blue looks like? Color is a sensation and varies depending on the person. In 1931, the International Commission on Illumination developed the mathematical limit of human vision in regards to color by finding the connections between what humans physiologically see as color, psychovisual studies, and wavelengths in the visible spectrum. And this is it. CIE 1931 XYZ color space, the gamut of human vision. There have been iterations of this model, but 1931 XYZ is still widely used. It is also referred to as a chromaticity model, literally meaning the quality of color independent of brightness. You might have seen something similar to this when buying a new laptop, TV, or monitor, where it shows you how much of that color model it can reproduce. Our camera sensor is calibrated to the standard range of colors using raw values to calculate color. So when it comes to capturing reality, a camera sensor actually does a better job than our own eyes. It captures more than we might perceive. And that is because everyone has a different reality, as in everyone responds to color differently. But a sensor doesn't. If you and I have the same camera and film the same thing from the same angle, it will record the same raw data. But our eyes, our mind, will process it differently than the person next to you. But still, this video isn't real. Every color captured by the camera ends up filtered, and depending on the screen you're watching this on, the color, brightness, chroma, and luma is different. And then our eyes are perceiving it differently. The raw numbers that we saw earlier are the closest that we get to the actual reality of the image captured. Everything that happens after is an interpretation, a process in which, after enough iterations, what was seen initially changes completely, but to our eyes is reality.
And as always, thanks for watching.
Hey there. Hey, thanks for watching this video. You should go over to H3H3 and check out a video they made. Ethan, Hila, what is that video?
Well, we made a great little spoof with your boy here, where we auditioned to be Vsauce 4 successfully. We've got a bunch of adventures you're gonna learn on. It's very educational, so make sure to smash that annotation button and Colin, jump on over to our channel, H3H3 Productions, featuring your boy here, Vsauce.
And Michael Stevens.
Oh, yes.
So it's a whole
footnote, Michael Stevens. Yeah. Footnote.
Very small.
So footnote. Smash it. Thanks for having us.
Hey, thanks guys. Hey, come on.
Goodbye. Aww.